guys. It's Nervous Energy back, and today I decided to play a Bard's Tale, which is something I'm actually really looking forward to. It's supposed to be really funny, just an RPG. I'm not really sure what else it's supposed to be. I know.
Would you like to hear a new story? Oh, very well, where shall we begin? The stronger the bard is, the more damage he can inflict with melee weapons. Shopkeepers will offer significant discounts to the bard if he has high charisma. Shopkeepers will offer significant discounts to the bard if he has high charisma. A high vitality will increase the bard's health, making him more difficult to defeat in battle. The stronger the bard is, the more damage he can inflict with melee weapons. Luck has a subtle effect on many aspects of the bard's adventures. A high dexterity allows the bard to inflict greater damage with ranged weapons.
I'm a bard, I need to be offer significant charismatic
to the bard if he has high charisma. Allows the bard to equip and use two-handed weapons. Allows the bard to fight with a dirk in one hand and
dirk.
A sword in the other. Allows the bard to equip and use a flail. The bard will automatically bash with his shield after blocking, stunning his enemy. Allows the bard to fight with a dirk in one hand and a sword in the other.
Allows I'm gonna go with two-handed weapons.
And use two-handed weapons. It had come to this at last. One man,
that's loud.
A poet and a rogue, with no friends to speak of, no one to mourn his passing, should it come to that. Even those beside him are no more boon companions than bond servants, summoned by sorcery and song, as cold and indifferent to him as the light of a wandering star. We've got to begin elsewhere. And not that long ago. A simple man he was, with a quick wit and a sharp tongue, an eye for the lasses, and a talent for keeping one step ahead of the law, come to Houghton to play his tunes and make his way. He found himself standing outside the Drunken Rat, a public house owned by the widow Mary McCrary. The bard readied his instrument, and prepared to ply his trade.
So, for anyone who doesn't know, this game is available on Xbox. If this looks interesting at all.
You drunken lots. Get off your backsides and kill it.
I'll save you, fair damsel.
Ah, what a strapping man you are to be saving me from that wee beastie.
I happen to be wandering by
wee
when
beastie.
I heard your cries over the rumbling of my empty belly. You aren't hurt, are you?
No, but aren't you no. A sweet one for asking? See, I've an idea. If you'd be willing to do a little job for me, I'd give you a good meal and a warm place to lay your head for the night.
I'd be only too happy to handle anything you'd like to heave my way.
Then it's a deal, for it's a wee rat problem I've got in my cellars, and if you could do away with them, I'd be ever so thankful.
Rats, you say? In the cellar? How cliche of you, love. But I'll forgive you this once.
You'll need a bigger sword than what you've got. In case you run into trouble.
Oh, and my sword is quite big enough to handle any troubles you might have.
Slick. So yeah, this game is available on Xbox if anyone wants to try and play it. I've been kind of, well, I won't call it a phase because it's been going on for years, but as of recently, I've been getting into, like, really getting into medieval stuff. I'm wearing medieval pants right now. I have a medieval shirt on the way. It's just, it's so fun. Oh, X. Beer. Wait, how come the bard isn't singing? I really want to go to a tavern one day, but there's none available where I live. So sad.
Hey, I understand your hesitation, stranger. There isn't enough ale in this town to get me to go down there. Then again, I'm a cowering sort.
Well, for someone who says he's not afraid of rats, you sure are procrastinating. If you were afraid, you can tell me. I won't have any interest in speaking with you any further, but you can tell me.
Ah, I see. Okay. Fucking got him.
Quest complete.
All hail the bard, killer and rodent bane, who has bravely made the cellars once again safe for buxom barmaids and wanton widows. Or has he?
No.
The bard, finding himself wreathed in flame, dashed up the stairs towards the safety of the tavern.
Damn, they don't give a shit.
Now we'll have another go at him with this.
You better hope I've cooled off when I return, or you're next.
He's really aggressive for a bard.
Who the hell are you? How'd you get down here?
Look, the stairs.
Don't be concerning yourself with such things right now. I'm here to help you with your rat problem. Any brute can swing a sword. If you really want to slay that hairy beastie, try playing this tune on that lute of yours.
Go on, clear off out of it. I've no use for you.
I'm not offering to go with you, laddie. I'm offering you a bit of song and magic that'll bring you back in one piece.
Great. So now the rat gets dinner and a show. If it's so bloody powerful, use it yourself and save me the trouble.
Would that I could. But I'm not a man of action like yourself. So do yourself a favor and take a little charity when it's offered, my boy.
That's a dick.
Show me what you got.
I guess granted I can understand. If I was on fire, I wouldn't be so friendly.
Before you head down there and face that huge rat, I'd like to be sure that you know your business. Would you like me to teach you a few wee things that'll help you get the best of any foes you might encounter?
I think I'm going to regret this, but I'll humor you, old man.
Good job, lad. You already know how to attack, but let's talk about defending yourself. Press the defend button.
Well, what are you on about?
God, I'm learning
You're
the tutorial.
You're completely insane, aren't you? You know, I ran into this other guy once. He kept talking about mice I couldn't see. Now I'm blocking pretend blows. I hope you appreciate what I'm going through here and reward me sufficiently.
That was great, boyo. You'll notice that instead of holding down the button, you'll have to time your defense to the enemy's attack.
Of course I have to time it. How else am I going to block anything?
Now, laddie, let's teach you how to play that lute of yours and make some magic.
What? Does my name not mean anything to you? The bard? Did you not see me summon that rat a few moments ago?
Press the summon menu button.
You're not listening to a word I'm saying, are you?
You'll see several choices. These are the different types of beasties you'll eventually be able to summon. For now, let's summon that spider I taught you about.
At least. Finally.
This part is important, so listen up, laddie. The creatures that you summon aren't under your complete control, but they will try to do what you wish to the
Skip
best of their ability.
Try in this, I know I clicked on the tutorial. Seems like
press the
getting antsy.
Button.
Getting a tiny bit antsy.
They become more aggressive.
Attack!
You're getting the hang of things now, aren't you, lad? You can experiment with different uses of the command buttons to develop your own strategies. Now, at times, you may want to get rid of a creature you've summoned. Simply go back into the same menu you've summoned him from and select him again. That's the way to get rid of an unwanted creature.
Great. Does that trick work on you as well?
Good luck against the rat, my boy.
In the future,
we'll
have to learn how to dodge these mysterious old man types.
The face of rat, then a demon. my loot?
Hail the bard, rat killer, and rodent bane, who's bravely made the cellar.
How about you tell the story and leave the sarcastic patronizing to me, okay?
My loot? Loot?
Away again, did ya? Go back to where you came from and leave the fighting to those who've got the guts for it.
I've plenty of guts, milady, which is why you needn't trouble yourself about that rat any longer.
You mean it's dead? Oh, thank you. I can't tell you how grateful I am.
Grateful?
'Twas the least I could do for a damsel in distress. Now, how about that meal?
Why don't you wait while I fix you some leftovers? Oh, and your room in the back is almost ready.
Having spent a lonely night in a somewhat uncomfortable and shabby bed, the bard awoke the next morning in a foul humor.
You should go speak with that strange friend of yours. He was starting to scare away my regular customers. I had to chase him out.
Hang on, I gotta talk to this lady. In her own little world.
Yeah, so you killed a rat. What do you want, a medal?
So I needed a break from Dark Souls 2, and so I started playing The Binding of Isaac, which was a lot more stressful with controls that I'm not used to at all. So I figured I'd try this game one more time. The first time I tried to run this, I have epilepsy, and it was the most seizure-inducing light show. So we had to erase it and come up with a whole other system.
Sounds a little dangerous to me. I don't care much for trow. I think I'll pass.
Come now, boy. What's a little danger when compared to power?
Didn't it's true.
That little trick I showed you help you get in good with the Widow McCrary? If it's a skin you're worried about, I will wee trinket here that'll keep you safe from harm.
This amulet was made by a powerful sorceress. It can summon her spirit to heal your wounds in battle. You'll need adder stones to provide the necessary mystical power. If you like, you can even use multiple stones for even greater effect. Here, laddie, try it out.
Yay!